الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله
أشهد أن لا
أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله
أشهد أن
أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة
اللهم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله
حي على الصلاة
اللهم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله
حي على الفلاح
اللهم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله
حي على الفلاح
اللهم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العظيم
الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر
لا إله إلا الله
اللهم رب ازدعوا تاما والصلاة القائمة على سيدنا محمد الوسيلة والفضيلة وبعث الله مقام محمد وبعث إنك لا تغفر معاك رضيت بالله ربا والإسلام دينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وصلي لهم على بلهم وعلى صحبه وسلم سلام كثيرا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفي من خلقه وحبيبه أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ومحى الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فصلاة وسلاما على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ونزعنا ما في صدورهم من غل إخوانا على سرر متقابلين. وكان الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم دائما يكثر من قول يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلبي على دينك أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد all praise to Allah, all praise to Allah, the one, the only, the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that he is the creator of this universe and he is the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام is his messenger. True mercy is sent to us. If we follow his path, inshallah we'll be in Jannah. أما بعد always when we go to a meeting or go to a conference or go to meet someone you take a shower put some perfume and enjoy your time you know to be fresh with that I have a story I'll start with a story and then let's see what do I mean by that the story is a man when you get married you know everyone gets married you have to sit with your wife in the kitchen because she's cooking And imagine now when you're sitting with her in the kitchen, she's cooking food, beautiful food, tastes perfect. And after she's done, she washes the pot from the outside and leave what's inside. And the second day you sit with her because you're married, newly married, you need to eat everything. She cooks in the same pot. And okay, maybe she missed it. Okay, ignore her. And then she cleans outside and leaves the inside. The third day, she did the same. And now, you see a problem. The food that remains from yesterday and the day before is rotten. It's not good. You're cooking in the same pot, you have to clean the inside too. Then, what should you do? Definitely, hopefully, after 3 days of marriage, you will not be yelling. Hopefully, no yelling. That time, after 3 days of marriage, no yelling. Inshallah, you'll be sleeping outside the house. But no, you have to say it nicely and wisely. First, you ask the question, why you're doing that? She will tell you, oh, my mother, I saw my mother and saw my grandmother doing that. You need to fix the problem now. Do we do that now? Leave the story aside and let's go to ourselves. Do we do that every day, humanly? You come to the prayer, you go to meet your brothers, you wash outside. How about the inside? Is there a wash to the inside too? Is there a wash to the inside? Now, first, you need to know how to do it. How to fix the problem. Two, how to correct it. First, you have to identify the problem. You have a heart inside, you have a soul inside, you need to clean. Two, how to clean. Three, what's the consequences of the clean? This is the khutbah today. Then, first we have to identify the problem. Any problem. I have another story. But now, let's get a real one from the Prophet ﷺ. A Prophet ﷺ was sitting with his brothers, companions, sahaba, and he's sitting and said, now a man from Ahlul Jannah will come from that door. This means that the Prophet didn't even know who's coming in. A man from that door is from Ahlul Jannah. A man came, a normal man, even I don't know his name, came in, okay. And he sat and then he left. Second day, the Prophet said, يَدْخُلُ عَلَيْكُمُ الْآنَ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. A man from this door will come from Jannah. And again, the same man came. And for the third day, the Prophet said the same thing. أَيَدْخُلُ عَلَيْكُمُ الْآنَ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. And the same man came. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As, who's that man? What he's doing? He's a normal person. Even he's not Omar, Abu Bakr, Uthman. These beautiful names, high names. He's a normal man coming in. I have to know. I cannot. I have to know. He went and told the man, I have a kind of a fight with my father. I want to stay with you for 3 days. And at that time, by the way, it's normal. It's normal that someone can drop you at your house and say, I want to stay for 3 days. Imagine I come to your house, I say, I want to stay with you even for 1 day. Okay, get a hotel. Yeah, I know what you mean. At that time, the karam, the generosity was there. And the man told him, sit. Let me put a side thing, even though it's not related to the khutbah. Why you do that? At that time, what they had in their houses? Four walls and a ceiling, and that's about it. There's nothing in the house. You sleep anywhere. Now in our houses, anywhere, beds, 3 bedrooms, and a kitchen, and whatever, and the fridge, because we're scared. You look and you'll see that. That's what I think. Anyway, this is a side thing, but it's not important. Let's go back to Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As. Abdullah ibn Amr sat with him, the man, after Aisha prayer with the Prophet. He slept, he waked up at Fajr prayer, he went to Fajr prayer, and normal he works. The second day he did the same, the third day he did the same. Nothing. He did not know something special. And Abdullah ibn Amr As told him, the Prophet said that 3 times, that you're from Ahlul Jannah. And I didn't see anything special about you. What did you do? I don't see anything. And the Sahabi told him, I don't know. As you can see, I'm normal. Like any of us, I'm normal. He said, okay, maybe it's a special thing for you. Maybe. And Abdullah ibn Amr was trying, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As was leaving, and the Sahabi said, hold. Said, what? And the man told him, maybe I do one thing. He said, what? Before I go to sleep, I don't have any grudges against anyone. I don't have anything against anyone. And clear my heart. I cleanse my heart from any hate to anyone. And Abdullah ibn Amr Rasulullah, with that, you're going to Jannah. And when I thought about it, oh, it's easy. I don't hate you. I don't hate my brother. It's easy. No, it's not. It's not easy. At all. I'll tell you a simple example. Everyone applies it for himself. Your brother from your father and mother, he took 1 meter extra from you. You think that. How many years you haven't talked to him? Years you haven't talked to him. Your sister told you a bad thing one day. She was angry. She talked to you badly. Until now you have the grudges against her. You don't, I cannot talk to her. Your sister. How about me with my loud voice? How about the brother who sometimes he had problems in house and he said something that you cannot handle. He doesn't have to tell you everything. The houses, all the houses have secrets. He doesn't have to tell you my secret. But you cannot handle that. You're hurt. How to relieve that? How to get rid of this anger problem? I'm not saying that the anger problem, I want to marry someone or get some money. No. My anger problem about you as a Muslim. I see you once or two times at dar or mosque and masjid, and that's about it. Or definitely your brother or sister who you don't talk to, or your father, father who didn't put you in his will, or he didn't give you a lot of money that you're expecting. How many of us are doing that? I know people, they don't talk to their brother for almost 50 years, because of some meter in the land. I know everyone, some of us are holding so much. And at the end, they go away with nothing. Which is, sometimes, I question even why we are doing what we are doing. Wallahi, when you think about it a little bit, why we are fighting all this fight for nothing? At the end, you will go in Glen Abbey and sleep there forever. Why you have these grudges for simple things? Alhamdulillah, I have food in my stomach, I have water, I have shelter. Alhamdulillah. Our people in Gaza or Palestine or anywhere, Syria, Egypt, in jail or in bad places. Or in India, they're killing anywhere, everywhere. Alhamdulillah. They really say always Alhamdulillah. Now, with that being said, what should we do? How can we clean that? One of the worst enemies of the heart, I'll start with, I have 5 of them. Hopefully, this will help us identify the problem. We need to identify, I told you in the beginning, identify the problem, fixing the problem, how to deal with after that. How to identify the problem? First, how to get the disease? The first thing that get disease, al-ghaiba. You know, my brother Naeem is getting that, he's getting the pictures, he's getting famous because of the YouTube, you know? My brother is doing that. Right? Grudges coming, building the grudge and building the thing in my heart. Oh, this doctor is getting this amount of money and he's doing that. You don't know what everyone is doing. I have to say it. No, come on. How dare he get that? I am better than him, right? Like the shaitan, I'm better than him. SubhanAllah. That's the first thing. And envy. Envy. I envy you what you have. Why you have that? We're missing what? Alhamdulillah. 3. Al-qila wal-qal. You always talk about someone. I talk about my brother. Oh, he's sitting. Why he's sitting? Why he's doing that? Lucky him. Maybe he cannot sit on the ground. Give him the excuse. Oh, why this brother is doing that? Why the brother is lucky revert? He came to Islam, his hasanat is gone. His sayyat is gone. And now he have extra hasanat. Why I don't have that? Why? Hasad. Envy. Why we have that? 4. This is, by the way, everything is building up. I'm trying to identify the problem. See which problem do you have, because everyone has a different problem. Try to find your problem. Four, try to, we said, غيبة, talking about you, envy, talking a lot about you, and thinking that Allah didn't give you enough. Asking Allah, many people, have you seen that? Some people said, why Allah didn't give me that Rolls Royce? Why Allah didn't give me this beautiful wife? Always, by the way, I saw that. Always when you debate with women, always they are beautiful or rich. I don't see anyone who say, oh, why his wife is more knowledgeable in Islam than my wife? I haven't seen that until now, but anyway. Always she's rich or she's beautiful. Always that. Subhanallah. As if you marry this girl, you'll be the most happier. Usually it's not happening. Now, how to fix these problems? How to fix this? I'm missing one. I don't know what is the fifth one. That's why I forgot to write it down. How to fix these problems? One, give excuses to the brother. My brother didn't say, tell me good morning today. He didn't say salam. Maybe he has a problem. Ask him. The brother is sitting on the chair. Maybe he has a problem. Go and say salam to him. Ask him. Simple things. Maybe your brother is not talking to you. Then what should you do? Remember the hadith. What's the hadith? وَخَيْرُهُمَا بَدَأَ السَّلَامِ. There's a hadith, by the way, like that. خَيْرُهُمَا. The best of you, that is if you start with saying salam first. Be the good one. Be the better one. Say salam to him. He didn't respond. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud saying, I want everyone who I say salam to him, he doesn't respond. Why? He said that if you say salam to a brother and he didn't respond, Allah would send an angel to respond. That's why he used to do what? To go in the market and say salam alaikum to everyone he meets. Some people respond, some people don't. He doesn't care. First, remember, assalamu alaikum takes 10 hasanat, just saying it. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, 20. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, 30. Imagine, 30 hasanat in 2 seconds. Wow, it's a free hasanat, come on, do it, get it, reach for it. And if you respond, you take extra, because I enforce you now to say it to me. Imagine. He didn't respond. Better. Jazakallah khair. Angel will come. But definitely I want everyone to respond. Get excuse. Two, have a cleansed heart. Don't have any grudges against anyone. How to have that? Giving excuses. Azar. They say that give a 70 excuse to all brothers. 70. And if you didn't find any of the 70 applies to your brother, say that there is an excuse I don't know anything about. Maybe there is an excuse, I don't know it. Excuses the brother. Three, love each one. When you see him, I remember, and I always say, and I always emphasize, smile. Smile to the brothers around you. Smile takes 50% of the way, of the problem. Wallahi, I tried it. Try it yourself. 50% of the problem goes with a smile. And it's up to you to get the other 50. Just a smile to your brother, you get closer to him 50%. And the 50%, other 50% you have to work on. Wow. I wish all things in life is like that. That's why I'm trying to emphasize smile and smile and smile. Lastly but not least, for the second part is what? Forgive. Forgive. You know the story of Sayyidina Abu Bakr when Mistah, his cousin, talked about Sayyidina Aisha, or mother Aisha, and told that she committed adultery. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr was so angry. He was giving him money. He was giving him money. He was supporting him. He said, I will not do it. I will not do it. He's condemning my daughter. How can I support him? And Allah gave a blame to Sayyidina Abu Bakr. A blame, imagine. Blame to Sayyidina Abu Bakr. I'm giving, he's giving his money and you're cursing my daughter and I still, and Allah is giving my tab to me. Yes, he's Abu Bakr. He's a higher rank. And if you want to join, do it. Allah told him, فَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَعْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ فَلْيَعْفُوا. A command. Give af, forgiveness. And give relief. تسامح. تسامح is a bigger word than relief. Don't you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you? Don't you want that? Everyone loves that. You want Allah to forgive you? Then give. Reach out. By money, by effort, by call. Subhanallah, these fools now, you can call anywhere in the world. Simple. What, you know what's hard? To click. This is the hard part. The hard part is to click your brother name or sister name. The easy part is connection. And the hard part when you call and they don't respond. Alhamdulillah, I'm gone. I'm done my job. Thank you. Done. No. You didn't do your job. Try again. Try again. This word, try again, will help you to relieve. Remember that this is the ways. I'll tell you what's coming after. Inshallah, you relieve. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروا يا فوز المستغفرين. أستغفر الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. أما بعد, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, لا تباغضوا ولا تحاسدوا ولا تدابروا وكونوا عباد الله إخوانا ولا يحل لمسلم أن يهجر أخاه فوق ثلاث. Allah, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, don't hate each other, don't envy each other, don't give your backs to each other, and be a brothers, true brothers to each other. And you have to know that it's forbidden to ignore your brother for more than 3 days. Just 3 days. Not 3 years, 3 days. I'll give you another hadith now which scared me and myself. Really, I didn't know it's there. Then, to help after, because again, the hearts are hard to manage. It's not that simple. What should you do? Make dua. Oh Allah, help me to get closer to my brother. Oh Allah, relieve my heart from any agony. Oh Allah, accept my trial. Because it's hard. I know it's hard. I'm not saying it's simple. You wash your body outside, how much? Soap, and make sure that you're clean, and go to the closed areas, and everything. You do everything. Just every day or 2 days or 3 days, hopefully not more than a week, hopefully. Hopefully you wash it less than that. But anyway, you do that every day. Your heart, does it need a little bit more? Hopefully you do that. Look at this hadith. And I'll finish with these two hadiths, inshallah. The first one, لا يحل لمسلم أن يهجر أخاه فوق ثلاث فمن هجر فوق ثلاث فمات دخل النار. The meaning, if you don't talk to your brother for 3 days continuous and you die, you go to hellfire. I tell you another hadith which is not here. The hadith which I remember now, Laylatul Qadr. Everyone is searching for Laylatul Qadr. And the Prophet one day, he was going out to tell the Muslimin, when is Laylatul Qadr? And he found two people are fighting. And it was raised. And the Prophet said that, I was coming to tell you Laylatul Qadr, but I found two people fighting. And that's why it raised. I couldn't tell you. Tashahun. How many goodness that we had if we know Laylatul Qadr, when these two, just two fighting, raised it. Now the scariest hadith that I didn't see before. Wallahi, I didn't see before. I was extremely scared. Look at this. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من هجر أخاه سنة فهو كسفك دمه فكيف يهجره فكيف إذا يهجراني إيه لا مش ده قال رسول من هجر أخاه سنة فهو كسفك دمي. من هجر أخاه سنة فهو كسفك دمي. If you don't talk to your brother for a whole year as if you killed him. How many brothers did we kill in our lives? How many? والله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. والله I tell myself even that how many brothers I had a fight with them and I don't talk to him anymore. How? I don't know. I don't know. May Allah forgive us. Then what should we do to relieve ourselves, hopefully, and come back to the right path? One, make sure that you forgive everyone. And I'm hoping I'm talking from here. Please forgive me if I did something wrong, especially with my loud voice, especially sometimes I get angry. We're human. Forgive each other. Two, connect. Connect, talk. Three, pray to Allah to help us and forgive us. Because without that, we are all in trouble. Remember, I'll finish with that, the bridges over the hellfire. I told you before there are 7 bridges on the hellfire. The Sirat have 7 stop signs, stops. The first one is La ilaha illallah and the Prophet in your time. 2, prayer. 3, fasting. 4, zakah. 5, hajj. The 6th one, and most of the ulama said this is the hardest and worst of all. Which one? Huquq al-ibad. Whatever I owe you or you owe me. John, he fell in the first one because he's not a Muslim. He fell from the first one. But he will come to the 6th one. Why didn't you show me Islam? Why did you see me and do something wrong and you didn't stop me? I'm talking about John now. I'm not talking about Muhammad or Ahmed. We didn't smile on his face or he's envied him or. Or you don't talk to him for years. And the 7th is, which everyone is happy now. Oh, Jannah is there. Time to go. No, hold. What? Oh, Rahim. The connection to everyone. Your brother, your sister, your father, your mom. My father is dead. Alhamdulillah. Oh, you're missing dua to him or to her, your mother. Why didn't you make dua to him? Remember, and I'll finish with that. Between the sujood, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, Subhan Rabbi al-A'la, Subhan, and you sit. Don't sit quietly. What do you say? Allahumma ghafirli. ولوالدي والمسلمين أجمعين. Oh Allah, forgive me, forgive my parents, and forgive everyone. Or اللهم اغفر لي ولوالدي ولأصحاب الحق علي. Oh Allah, forgive me and forgive my parents and forgive anyone who I owe him anything. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت. اللهم توفنا مسلمين. اللهم تقبل منا رمضان. اللهم تقبل منا رمضان. اللهم تقبل منا رمضان. اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم عليك بالظالمين. اللهم عليك بالظالمين. اللهم اطعم جائعهم واسق عطشانهم وتقبل شهداءهم ووقف هذه الحرب الغاشمة يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لنا تقصيرنا يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم ورحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
Fill the gap. Go in. استو في الكعب. استو تراصوا اعتدلوا. يا رب اغفر لي ذنبي. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله اكبر. اللهم بعد بيني وبينك بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر النفعة الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت. اللهم صل على عبدك ونبيك محمد في الأولين والآخرين. اللهم تقبل منا رمضان. اللهم تقبل منا رمضان. اللهم تقبل منا رمضان. اللهم عليك بالظالمين. اللهم عليك بالظالمين. اللهم وقف هذه الحرب الغاشمة. اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم انصرهم نصر المؤزرة. اللهم تقبل شهداءهم واطعم جائعهم واسق عطشانهم واغفر لنا يا رب العالمين تقصيرنا. اللهم اغفر لنا تقصيرنا وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وصل اللهم نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم كثيرا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله العظيم. 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 اللهم إني أعوذ بك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك.